Now we are going to study motion in two dimensions. If we talk about motion in two dimensions, we can simply state it as motion in a plane. As till now we have studied about rectilinear motion, which was the motion of a particle in a straight line. If particle starts moving in a plane, then it is termed as motion in two dimensions. Say, in a two-dimensional coordinate system, if we analyze a 2D motion, like say if a particle starts from point A and say it goes to a point B following this path. This is a two-dimensional motion because you can see as the particle is moving along with its motion, its X coordinate as well as its Y coordinate both are simultaneously changing. Say particle is at a point P. Say this is a particle, it is moving with a velocity vector which is along the tangent of the particle at this point. Say at any instant of time, it is at position coordinates x and y. If it is moving, we can simply state x coordinate as well as y coordinate both are changing. This velocity will also have two components. Say at this position, at this point P, the velocity is having an angle, velocity vector is making an angle theta with the x direction. Then the horizontal component of this velocity can be written as V cos theta and its vertical component can be written as V sin theta. Here we can simply write velocity component in x direction as V cos theta and velocity component in y direction as V sin theta. So these are the velocity component with which the particle is moving in x as well as in y direction. So as the particle moves, x coordinate of particle is also moving, which can be written as vx, that is v cos theta. Y coordinate is also moving with velocity vy, which is v sin theta. So at this position of time, the velocity vector of particle can be written as vx I cap plus vy j cap. And as a particle goes from point A to point B along this path, we can say the x coordinate of particle moves along with this motion. If we just draw the projection of particle on x axis, this x coordinate is moving or starting from the point x A and it will reach the position x B. Simply y coordinate, if we talk, it first goes up to this position, which is the maximum height. And then it comes down, y coordinate goes down and then again it fluctuates and finally it reaches a position yb. So we can say in this two dimensional motion, x as well as y coordinate of the particles are simultaneously changing. At any instant of time, the velocity can be resolved in two components. One is with which it is moving in x direction, other is with which it is moving in y direction. Here vx and vy can be simply given by v cos theta and v sin theta. At any instant we want to calculate the magnitude of this velocity. This can be written as the magnitude of vector, that is vx square plus vy square. If we want to calculate this angle theta, so we can simply write tan theta is equals to vy upon vx, or the angle which velocity vector makes with the positive direction of x axis or the slope angle of the curve can be given as tan inverse of Vy by Vx. Both of these relations are going to be extensively used in various cases. We can also write down a note for this two dimensional motion. Whenever we'll analyze this motion, we can simply state a two dimensional motion can be analyzed by splitting it into two perpendicular one-dimensional motions with time as a common variable. Because we can simply state here time is same when particle is at position A, both of its coordinate x A and y A are at a particular instant at these values. When it moves, at the same time x and y are simultaneously changing and finally reaches x B and y B. Say y B is the final y position of this point B. So you can say in this particular motion, throughout motion, time will be taken as a common variable for these two one-dimensional motion. One is along x-axis, other is along y-axis. This motion between A and B, when combined, we are going to get the complete two-dimensional motion. You can also write that in 2D motion, all the analysis of one-dimensional motion, that is rectilinear motion, can be applied along x and y directions simultaneously. Say if a particle is moving in x and y directions simultaneously or in two-dimensional motion, we can write along x direction, the velocity of particle in x direction can be written as dx by dt. And acceleration in x direction we can write as dvx by dt, or it can be further written as vx dvx upon dx. This is the way how we use the relations of velocity and acceleration in rectilinear motion. Similarly, along y direction we can use the similar result. Velocity in y direction we can write dy by dt. And acceleration in y direction we can write dvy by dt, or we can use it vy dvy over dy. This is the way how we use. We can also analyze one example which will make the concept relatively clear. Say a particle moves in a 2D motion such that its position depends on time as x is equals to 4t square plus 2t plus 3 and y is equals to 5t plus 7. See, this is the position of particle which is given as a function of time to us, and we are required to find the velocity of particle at t equals to 2 second. We are required to find the velocity at t equals to 2 second. In solution, you can directly use velocity in x direction can be written as dx by dt. On differentiating this, we are going to get 80 plus 2 meters per second. And similarly, velocity in y direction will be dy by dt. It can be written as simply 5 meters per second. We are required to find at t equals to 2 second. So you can see velocity in x direction at t equals to 2 second is, this will be 18 to 2, 16 plus 2, it is 18 meters per second. And velocity in y direction will be 5 meters per second. So from here we can state net velocity can be written as 18 I cap plus 5 j cap. This is the velocity vector of particle at t equals to 2 second. If you wish, you can calculate the magnitude, that is root of 18 square plus 5 square, and the angle made by the velocity vector with the x-axis or the slope angle can be written as 10 inverse of 5 by 18. So these are our answers to this question. And you can see we have just applied the concept of rectilinear motion simultaneously in x direction as well as in y direction, and we are getting the final result.